Welcome to the TMC Newsroom. My name is Rich Tarani. Thanks for watching us today. This week we are in Boston, Massachusetts, and we are meeting with some of the leading companies in the technology space. And as part of this continuing series of companies from New England, I'd like to introduce you to Matthew Growney, who is a president and CEO of Isabella Products. Matthew, how are you?
Great. Thanks, Rich. Thanks for having me.
So I thought we'd start by talking a little bit about what your company does and the products that you make.
Sure. Isabella Products is one of the first mobile internet device and services companies. We've made a very conscious effort at creating devices and services that take advantage of the mobile internet, but create a very simplistic yet valued experience for a consumer. So separate from maybe the more traditional M2M meter reading type of mobile connected devices, we look at connecting things that have previously not been connected and using our technology to create a wow experience for those consumers.
So what sorts of traditional products do you consider a mobile internet device? Like, are tablets included in that?
Absolutely. They're kind of these three very loose criteria for defining a mobile internet device. The first is a device has to be connected to the internet, naturally. Second is that it's mobile or portable. And third is that it runs some sort of intelligent operating system. Those three together kind of loosely define, whether it's in Wiki or some of the industry folks, what a mobile internet device is.
Fantastic. Now, I know you are also playing in the tablet space, and I was wondering if you could tell us a little bit about what you're doing there.
Sure. About 3 or 4 weeks ago, we announced the unveiling of a device that we're building called Fable. Fable will be the first children's tablet. And what's unique about it is not only does it take advantage of the e-reader space and all the content that's being developed digitally for children, but it also combines things like drawing, artwork, photos with a computing device specifically dedicated to children. So that child's experience is not just consuming content, but also they have the ability now to create content and be part of the publishing world themselves, whether it's through photos or drawing or other forms of communication that the tablet allows.
What age range is it designed for?
The device today is targeted to two demographics, 5 to 8 years old and 9 to 11 or 12. And that's always in the kids' space, plus or minus up or down 1 or 2 years. So it'll be everything from drawing, coloring sheets, to children's coloring books, to wonderful content from folks like Houghton Mifflin, so Curious George and others, and their ability to draw, so they can create photos. And the unique part about Isabella is it takes full advantage of the mobile internet. And so that's not a one-way experience, that's a two-way experience. So a child can, on Fable, draw and create artwork and send it over the mobile network to their mother or their grandmother's frame or their iPad or their email address. So it's a very immersive and interactive experience.
Now, is pricing available for?
Ranges, and we're really targeting the device to be somewhere in the $149 to $179 MSRP.
Okay.
We don't anticipate subsidies at this point, so it's a $149, $179. We believe it's important that the device certainly is affordable. But in the same sense, when you look at some educational toys today, they're approaching the $60, $70 price range for a toy itself. And then cartridges at $20 each. And so quickly, if you have a toy that requires 4 or 5 cartridges at $20, you're already at the $150, $160 price range.
Well, I think in that range, you've also got a DSi, right, which is about DSi XL is in the $170 range. I think it's around there.
Yeah.
And the cartridges are in the $30, $40
that's
range,
right,
if I'm not mistaken. So that's it's a compelling value proposition. But then you don't have all those, you don't have all the options of the games, I guess, right?
That's correct. We offer a game package that's really more tied towards the curriculum of the e-reader or the publisher. So we're not a shoot 'em up game application on Fable. It's meant more to supplement a specific theme for children, whether that's counting, learning, reading, alphabets, nutrition. We let our children's publishers, like Houghton Mifflin and others, help pair the e-reading books with certain games so that there's really more of a thematic experience. And then the child can certainly interact, interpret, and then reciprocate by creating, you know, things that they've been kind of excited about through the game, through the book, in their own content creation.
Well, I'm sure a lot of parents are interested in learning more about that product when it comes out.
Yes, we're very excited. We're looking at a back-to-school 2011 launch date. And so we're around, we'll show up probably somewhere in the next 3 or 4 months with, you know, kind of a very robust first beta run of devices.
Great, good luck. Now, I know you're also, you're embarking upon a, is it a hardware and services initiative as well? And I was hoping to learn more about that.
Sure. We are, at Isabella, focused not just on a great device experience, but we actually believe that a device experience really becomes unrivaled if it's part of a superior services experience. And I think in the past what you've seen is many hardware-only products have failed, not because of the user interface or the colors they chose or the application on the device, but really because it didn't have a value-add service. The reason why Apple and Amazon do so well is not just the device and the device experience, but it's because it is very, very robustly paired to an iTunes or a MobileMe, or in the case of Kindle, it's paired to Amazon.com. So Isabella has taken that same model and said, in order for us to build great devices like Fable or like Visit, we really need a services platform, one that manages the content itself, one that manages the communication protocol, one that manages the subscriber and all of his or her data, one that also is able to store securely and safely the connections between the device subscribers and the back end and their content, and build that robust platform, which we did in a what we call a CMS, a content management system known as VisitMe. And so VisitMe acts as this very safe and secure content management system that Visit and Fable and a variety of other devices are tied to or will be tied to, that we think is key to having a successful hardware business. And that delicate balance between a service layer and compelling hardware and clients is what we think, you know, kind of the future for mobile internet devices and industry, and certainly something that Isabella takes enormous pride in developing.
Specifically, what are some of the benefits, like in the real world, what does VisitMe.com allow me to do?
VisitMe allows you to tie your device experience to third-party content in a very secure and safe environment. So there's a variety of encryption, there's a variety of storage, there's a variety of managing of the content itself. It allows you also to cache and compress the data from a native file size that could be megabytes to a very slim package that then gets properly scheduled to be sent over a narrowband network like cellular. So if I had, you know, all the bandwidth in the entire world, which of course does not exist in the mobile environment, it wouldn't be an issue. But since we're talking about mobile and we're talking about, you know, quality of service and carrier grade, we want to be very mindful of how we send data across the cellular network to those devices. And so VisitMe has a very, very conscious kind of approach to caching and compressing and scheduling content that goes down to the network, over the network into the devices. It also allows you to control your communication with your friends and family. So VisitMe also allows a white list of contacts to be part of your experience.
Right.
And so you wouldn't want just anybody to have access to your wife's frame or your daughter's Fable. You only invite a delicate, you know, very sensitive group of close-knit friends and family to be part of that experience. And so VisitMe also acts as that very secure community.
So it's an interface for sharing. So if I take a photo, I can upload it to all my Isabella devices and have that photo show up.
That's right. Or books or artwork in the future. All the content that you have across your different devices are stored very securely up at VisitMe. And if you want to invite your sister to be able to send content to your daughter's Fable or to your wife's Visit Frame, she is invited also through the web interface and then becomes a whitelisted member of the community, so that you have that security and safety of knowing that you've already permitted certain groups to have access to those devices.
So what other sorts of products are there that we haven't talked about that your company has?
So there's a new device, which I will give you kind of the sketchy details about because it has not quite been announced. It will be announced at CES. But we're working on a third product that is more of a parasite play. It is a very small form factor, a USB form factor, but it's one that will allow you to send content also to a whole host of USB hosts. Yeah, or a whole collection of different USB products. And so it's kind of like putting an application on a dedicated stick and letting that stick go to different devices and allow us to communicate with it. And so we will, you know, kind of iron out all the details for you at CES. But it's an example of a very, very small footprint, a very, you know, kind of mass market opportunity that will go into a whole host of devices that exist today and allow us to connect those previously unconnected devices to the Visit Me mobile backend.
Very cool. So we're looking forward to seeing that, and hopefully you'll be back in the program once that product is out to talk some more with us.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Richard.